So Malia, show us where the collision marks are that you found.
So there's like multiple collision marks.
Oh my gosh, look at that one.
Yeah.
I'm Judy Bowes. I'm looking at how architecture impacts wildlife, particularly birds. We can see where birds have flown towards the reflections in this glass, and we can see their body mass hit the window and then their wingspan as well. I study bird building collisions and how it relates to architecture. And so bird building collisions are when a bird is flying towards a building that has glass surface area that is reflective or transparent. So if they're flying 30 miles per hour, which is really common, they'll be flying towards a tree that looks like any other tree, but it's actually a reflection. And so they, for the most part, can hit head on and it's an instant death. We're losing 1 billion birds each year in just the United States due to collisions, and our estimate could be as high as 15,000 birds a year on our campus. Okay, let's start at that corner. The reason why we're collecting data on our campus is that we want to make sure that we have a set of data for our location and specifically our campus so that we can make more informed design decisions.
Oh, these windows.
We're looking for the actual dead body of a bird or feather piles that have shown that a bird died there.
And it's just like tufts.
We only find about 10% of the birds that actually hit the windows. So the other 90% are being scavenged by raccoons and squirrels and coyotes, but we think mainly crows. We have found 20 different species of birds. And of those 20 species, 10 of them are in decline.
For me, at least, it's not really that gross. It's more just like you feel sad that the bird died because we put a building where it should have been living.
This is a design problem, not a bird problem. We have to use some sort of marker on the glass surface area to tell birds that this is a solid surface, you can't fly through it, or the patterns that we have on the glass are too close together and you can't fly between them. We have been studying the pattern at the Gallagher Library. This is spaced very close together, about a half centimeter. Various species of birds in varying sizes have flown straight towards these reflections and diverted last minute, so we know that they can see this pattern. It's a big eye-opener for most people, particularly architects. I believe that we can just treat hot spots on buildings, and we don't have to treat every square foot of glass surface area. It's our responsibility, I believe, to protect living things and to prevent collisions.